Hello friends, welcome back to the another video lecture of OOP1 subject. Currently we are discussing about the collection interface. So in it we have seen the structure. After it we have discussed about the iterator and its method. What is the collection and its method? List, array list and linked list. Now we will discuss about the vectors. So it is the similar to array list but with two differences. First one is vector is synchronized. At the time of array list we have discussed the array list is not synchronized but vector will be synchronized. Vector contains many legacy methods that are not part of the collection framework. Vector will have the some other methods that will not included into the collection framework. To create an object of vector we will have the method like vector then object name is equal to new vector. Here this is the differences between the array list and vector. This type is array list and this side is vector. Array list is not synchronized where vector is synchronized. Array list is not a legacy class where vector is a legacy class. Array list increases in size by 50% of the array size where vector increases its size by doubling the array size. So this is the difference between the array list and vector. These are the methods of vector. Add method, clear method, add specific index, remove, then for the checking that it containing element or not, for that contains method, index of object method, size method and last index of method. So these are the methods that are available into the vector. So we will discuss it by example. This is the example of a vector demo. In it we have imported java.util.star. Our main method is there. Here we have created our object of vector class. So here vector v is equal to new vector. We have added some elements into the vector. Add hurry, add kd, add dp, add rd. So these are the elements of our vector. So we will print that elements by the printing simply a println statement. We will check the output. Our program is a vector demo, so java space vector demo dot java. So here our element is hurry, kd, dp and rd. So it is printing all the elements of our vector. If I want to add some element at specific index, then v, then add 123. So I will add the 23 at the first index. So here I check hurry 23, kd, dp, and rd. Okay. Here, if I want to make this vector only of string type, then I can use generics here. So here I will put the generics with the string. So this will include only elements of string data type. I will put string also here. If I declare it of string data type only, then I cannot add 23 into it because 23 is type of integer. So again I will run it by the only four elements which are of the string data type. So if I run it, then it will print hurry, kd, dp and rd. But if I add any element of different data type, means 23 at the index 1, so if I again run it, so it will show the error of 23 because 23 is type of integer and my vector is of generic string, so it can store only string data type into it, so I cannot store 23 into it. Okay, so if I want to store 23 into it, so I will remove this generic from it. Okay, so again I check that it is here, it is storing 23 into it. Okay, so this is the add method with specific index. If I want to remove 23, then I have remove method. With the remove method it will remove the element from the specific index 1. Okay, so here we can say it removed 23, Hari, KD, DP and ID is there. If I want to check Hari is present in that or not, so for that contains method is there and I have passed Hari into it, so it will check Hari is present into it or not. So we will check that. So it is printing that Hari is present. If I made a mistake into write Hari, then it will not return true, it will return false, then inner part of if statement will not executed. Okay, if I want to print specific index, if I want to print index of KD, then I have method index of, so with the index of method I can print the index of specific element. So specific element KD's index is the 1. Okay, if I add KD into last also, then I can check that KD is present 2 times, then what is the last index of KD? So here it's printing 4 because first index of KD is 1 and KD is 2 times appearing, so last index of KD is 4, so KD is available also 2 times, but last index is 4, at the 4 index KD is available. Okay, if I want to print the size of my vector, then I have method size, v dot size will print the size of the my vector. Okay, so size of the vector is 5 now, so v dot size method will, now v dot clear clear the vector all elements, so v dot clear. Now we will save it and again run it. Here I have to remove this. So vector is, then that is empty. So by v dot clear method we have cleared the our vector. So these are the methods and this is the demo of the vector. So this was the methods of vector. Now we will discuss about the stack. A stack is a data structure which follows LIFO, last in first out. Java stack class falls under the basic collection hierarchy, framework in which you can perform the basic operations such as push, pop, etc. To create a stack we will have syntax like stack, then object is equal to new stack, and empty, push, pop, pick and search, this method we can apply onto our stack. Then that is our queue. All queues except the DQ means double ended queue, support insertion at the end and deletion from the front. DQ means double ended queue supports insertion and deletion of element at the both ends. In order to use the queue interface, we need to instate a correct class. We can also have queue into linked list and also have queue into priority class. So by both the classes, we can create our queue. So syntaxes will be queue, object, new linked list, or queue, object, new priority queue. By both the classes, we can create our queue. Queue will have this type of methods: add, offer, pick, element, remove and poll. We will understand it by example. So this is our queue demo program. In it we have java.util.star, here it can be linked list, here it can be priority queue. In it our main method is there. Here we have created our queue by the linked list class, queue, then object our queue. By the for loop we have added 5 elements, 0 to 5, and I into 3 means it will be 0, 3, then 6, then 9 and 12. These elements will be there into our queue. After it, if we want to print, then it will print all the elements of the our queue. If we want to remove the head of queue, then we will have the method queue dot remove. It will remove elements from the front from the head. So by the q dot remove method we can remove our element. After it, if we print q, then q head will be removed, other elements will be printed. If we want to view the head, then pick method is there for the viewing the head. So q dot pick will show us the head of the q. If we want to check the size of q, then q dot size method is there for us. So we will run this program. Java space, our program name is q demo. So here we can see that this our system dot out q is printing 3, 6, 9, and 12. Again, if we want to remove our head, then q dot remove will remove the head. After it, if we print q, so our 0 is removed from here, our 3, 6, 9, 12, all the these elements are there. After it, if we view the head, then our pick method will share the head with us. So 3 is our head because 3 is at the front. And last, q dot size. So q dot size will return the 4 because our q size is 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So this is the demo of q. By this method, we can implement q into our Java. There is again a program that is priority queue. In priority queue, here we have taken a generic. If we want to remove, then also we can remove it. We have removed this generic here. Here our object is queue. Then queue dot at Amit. We have added Amit into it, Rachit into it, Rahul into it. Okay. If we want to take our head, the element method is there. If we want to take head, then our pick method is also there for the our priority queue. But priority queue is that in it all the elements will be stored into a manner. It can be a descending order, it can be a ascending order. If there is alphabet, then it will be stored into alphabetic manner. If that are into a numeric, then it will store into a numeric method. So for the priority queue, generics is compulsory, because if we have two type of data, one type of integer and second type of string, then we cannot create our priority queue. So here our generics will be string. If we have data type of string is there, if we want to store our other elements, then we will have to set that generics into it. So here q dot iterator, so we have initialized our iterator here. Hasnext method will check the elements are available into it or not. If that are available, then by the next method we will print it and we will go for the further. Q dot remove will remove the elements from the front. Here q dot poll method is also there. After removing two elements, we have our next iterator is there, and by this iterator again we will print the all elements here. So this is the example of priority queue. This is the example of q demo. Okay, so this is it for today's video lecture. If you like this video, then like, comment, and subscribe. Also share it with your friends. Thank you, friends.